Good morning, world. I don't know. Let's speak those things that are not as if they were. So we're speaking to the world because we believe that the message of the Holy Spirit is for the world, especially when you're spirit led and spirit fed. You feel me? So we're in the glorious, beautiful paradise that our great creator has given us, Laguna Beach. And, oh, by the way, got to pay the plug. So we just want to give all homage to Mr. Yahweh Productions for bringing this episode of Live Coffee with Yeshua. Where the best part, at least in my life, the best part of waking up is Yeshua fills your cup. Pay the plug. Oh, so much to talk about. But that's why I do this show. Because I have so much to talk about. But today I'm gonna stick on a topic. I'm gonna stick on a topic. But as you know, we bring a couple different things to this. We're gonna open the word a little bit. It's not gonna be long. We're gonna talk about specifically. I think what we're gonna talk about is Jezebel, Trump, end times, and marijuana. Four-way segue. Oh, a new word. Four-way segue. But first, I know I need to relax. Man, I've been getting beat up with anxieties. I got a lot going on. You all pray for me. I've been entertaining, as the word says in Hebrews, angels, good and bad. I had a run-in with Jezebel again, and the Lord brought me to this word. But first, Heavenly Father, we just thank you so much for being able to come before your throne. Just bless this word as we give it to your people. Silence all the noise around me as I'm hearing right now that song. Jesus, Jesus, you make the darkness tremble. Jesus, Jesus. Bring a shalom as you just did to my heart. To this message, to the people listening. In Yeshua's holy name, amen. That and God is so awesome because that's what he's been doing. I heard that song. And that song is Tremble. And it says, peace. Peace. Bring it all to peace. The storm surrounding me. Let it. Bring it to a halt. Hallelujah. I'm 100 miles per hour, but even I know when God is like, yo, hear me say, shh. You ever walk into the crib or walk into any a place and you just got that privilege to just walk on in? Well, God says sometimes I'd be walking right into it. It's right into the throne room like, ah! Like, yo, dad, and I did this and I saw this. He's like, yo, bruh, I was just watching a movie. Let me hit pause. I love my Father in heaven. Hallelujah. He's such a loving God. He's such a personable God. And when you're going through something and when you want to preach against something and you want to preach deliverance for somebody to get him out of something, he'll let you go through that something. Amen. And I'm going through something right now. Are you going through something? If you're honest with yourself, yes, you are. Because I told you I'm in Laguna Beach, aka California. And I'm so sorry that this is the Jezebel and the devil's throne for this area. But however, I'll tell you this one. When the spirit of Elijah, which is here, and the sons of God rise up, and in the power and the anointing of the Holy Spirit and the mantle of Elijah, this man will rise up. And you'll know, as the word says, God will expose. God is a literal God. Okay? And the mysteries and the oracles will be revealed to those whom seek him. That's the greatest gift. That's what Solomon was after. Solomon was hungry. Speaking of food. So, back at the ranch, Jezebel and Satan, this atmosphere here, they put it right where they want to. They exalted themselves, like the Bible says in Ezekiel. They hide in the hills, Laguna Hills. I was there the other day, beautiful houses. The Lord said, what would happen if a tsunami hit or lots of torrential downpour? I said, a mudslide into the ocean you go. That's prophetic. That's coming. Every time I look out on this ocean, I get visions of storms coming in, big tsunamis. And then I walk the beach and I see the faces of the kid, and it makes me want to pray. Although I can't wait for Yeshua to come, bittersweet, like the book of Revelation says. But this is, atmosphere is very, very clogged up. And I feel bad for these children. That's why I do my best, despite my stomach aches, despite my persecution, despite my heartaches, despite the slander, despite the warlocks, despite me being in the wilderness, despite all things, I can do all things through Christ Yeshua, who strengthens and empowers me to do his work, and he equips me to do the will of an evangelist. And I have not always done that the most appropriate way, but I come to you humbled and rightfully so. I have been put through hell, and I'm grateful to bring you this message. And I speak against this atmosphere of sexual morality, homosexuality. It's so clogged up. Everywhere I go, I'm feeling like these demonic sensations that are trying to draw me into a vanity, into a lustful spirit, an incubus spirit, and I cut it off at its head. Then an incubus spirit is a snake, and yes, it's in the word. It's a python, it's a snake, it's a normancer, and I come against it in the word of God. It says that no weapon formed against me, nor the things I pray for shall prosper. And I apply the word in the blood of Yeshua to these curses. And as we walk through it, as the Lord just gave me a vision, I saw myself in my car walking through it, and the Holy Spirit anointing cutting through the snake. That's what God means when he says, I will equip you for the mission. It's not always what we do physically. The work is done in the spirit. He has to lay the groundwork. When you let him lay the groundwork, you cannot get where you're going without God pruning you first. God will not allow you to go to the top of the music industry without pruning you first and preparing you, because it will get you to sell out. I met a young man who was in the entertainment industry. I will not name his name. And he told me some of the insides. And he told me that no matter who you are, unless you just want to be a stunt double, unless you just want to be a fill-in, you have to do favors. And one of his friends told him, hey man, just it doesn't make no difference. Just wear a glove while you're jerking off the executive. Oh, my father's told me that. He said, I've seen every lie, I've seen every rape, I've seen every manipulation, and my word does not lie. I will execute my judgment. But first, he has to right the wrongs in his church, so the church can get the what? Speck out of its eye. Oh, God, glory to God, for he is preaching from the living water. I'm just a vessel. He just cut the faucet on. Let him cut your faucet on. Amen. So the word. So earlier today, I've had bought some bad food. Romans 8:28. God says, stop always looking at the negative. This is a prophetic word for somebody. And let me focus on what I'm trying to show you. So what are you trying to show me, Yahweh? I got to just make sure this thing ain't getting too hot. Oh, okay. Hang on. We might have to cut this car on a little bit. We got to put the AC on. This phone get be getting hot. In good old California. Anyway, bear with me, guys. I'm just crying a little bit. So this is live. I ain't got no edit button. Yeah, man, this stuff is real. There was a while I couldn't cry. But let me get focused. A long while I couldn't cry. Hearts. The enemy was trying to harden my heart. That's the parable of the sower. He hardens the heart. He sends the floods. But as Minister Pastor Clark of Disciples Cross preached to me, awesome man of God, he said, when the enemy floodgates turn against you, God will raise up a standard. Amen. Glory. I speak that standard. Hallelujah. So I bought this food from the store, right? It was cantaloupe, it was mangoes, and it was milk. Here's the glory of God when you're walking in the spirit. I've been hearing sirens. I see things. I'm a seer. I'm a visionary. God gives me things. I'm a seer, as you would call a seer messenger. And am a hearer. So, I mean, I get it all types of ways, right? It's a lot, man. Warfare is pruned through what? The physical. In other words, warfare is pruned through you actually going through it. So if God wants to show you the spiritual realm, you're seeing in the what? The natural realm. Remember this. God uses the natural for the what? The supernatural. Thank you, Holy Spirit. So I get this. I get home. And I hear sirens as I'm getting ready to open the milk. And it made me draw attention from the TV. because I'm opening it as I'm looking at the TV, you know, and I hear the siren, so I look down, it was already open, the thing was pierced. What I've been through, the Lord said, you better, and it's not paranoia, no. But what I've been through, I've been served poison food. I've been served pork, and I don't eat that swine, which is poison to me. I've been given all types of bad prescription drugs. I mean, listen, the devil is after what God has in me, but I've seen God's hand too much upon me for me to quit now. Oh, I've strengthened, but through that shrinking, God has elevated me. He says, whoever exalts himself shall be humble. Whoever humbles himself shall be exalted. You don't ever want to be exalted too soon. That means you did it. God's perfect timing will envelope slowly. That's what I'm learning. And he'll start showing you things. And it's like a fine-tuned machine. That's a hint. So, in this whole process, so I have bad milk, I have bad fruit. And God says, don't get mad first, but what is it? And I said, he said, what have you been seeing in your spirit? It's like Ezekiel. And I said, what I've been seeing all over is bad water coming, famine's coming, the pale horse, the red horse is here. These things happen simultaneously. I had a vision. I told you the seals being opened up simultaneously. The knowledge knuckleheads, the bobbleheads, they, you know, oh, well, you know, no. No, God can do what he wants. We have birth pains. We have the seals open up concurrently. Right, we have all these things happening. Red horses here. We have, you know, divisions here. That's obvious, right? Look at everything. We have all the slander towards Trump, dishonoring the president. We have all these kids being disrespectful. That was prophesied. Nobody cares about the truth no more. Nobody cares about the president, right? And that's all because of this woman Jezebel. So, long story short, so I wait. Now, this morning, after the bad milk, I go open up my fruit. It's bad. Now the Lord spoke to me. That's what's coming. COVID was a preparation to that. Second thing, in my spirit, and then it came in the natural, like the transfiguration, 3D. I was driving slowly through a store, the same store complex. There's a karate place. And they had all the kids and the moms lined up, and they were shooting them, testing them, their temperature. Zzz, you've been there. Even churches are doing it. God says, look and pay attention. Because I said, hey, guys, have fun, which is a ministry. Because, you know, in sports and all that, everybody's all serious. No, have fun. These kids need to have fun. They need to have fun learning about Yeshua. That's why I say, have fun with me. Because he is love. He is fun. He is art. He is entertainment, too, as well. So the Lord said, look. And they were zapping these kids, and they were zapping, you know, the temperature. He said, that's preparing the people for the mark of the beast. COVID, the devil's not stupid. He knows that he copycatted God. He knows that God prepares the way for anything he has to do. The word says in Amos that God does nothing before what? Warning his prophets first. God has an order of things. In the kingdom of God, there's an order. The devil's confusion and disorder. So the devil wants to bring what? Confusion and disorder. So all that to say this. So how I know all this is certain? Well, Jezebel showed up like Jesus, manifested in the cashier, because she was more worried about how close I was to the register, my bag being on the thing, than the bad sour food. Right? So being spirit led, out of my mouth came, why are you worried about that? That's bad priorities. You need to worry about the three bad items that I got served out of your store. And I said, are you, and that spirit manifested, but this is just policy. I said, again, ma'am, are you having a bad day? And I said, God bless you. And I broke that spirit a little bit. I had to change the atmosphere. I had to speak into the atmosphere, shalom, as it says in the gospel, speak a peace, and that blessing will come upon a person of peace. You can't lose. Luke, right? And out of my mouth came, I said, you need to be worried about and stop serving all that bad food and stop worrying about, instead of worrying about all that control. Two trigger words, bad food control. And we finally get there. You ready, set, go. The word of God says, I know your works, Revelation 3:19. I know your works, your love and faith and service and patience and endurance, that your latter works exceed the first. But I have this against you, that you tolerate that woman Jezebel, church, who calls herself a prophetess, and is teaching and seducing my servants to practice sexual morality. That's spiritually and literal. Lots of places I've been to have homosexuality behind the pulpit, homosexuality a lot, the Lord showed me, in the natural and the physical, in the spirit realm, excuse me. of sexual sin in the worship teams. You watch out. Worship teams been carrying the church. These one-man bandstand pastor things, God is changing that. You want to know where God's working in? Find a church that they're trying to build a true fivefold ministry. There's a word, and it ain't itching. I know your works, your love and faith and service and patience and endurance. The church. I keep seeing ants in my spirit. Worker, worker, worker. I keep hearing Martha, Martha. Every church I've been going into, I've been blowing this shofar and saying, Lazarus! Wake up! You tolerate that woman Jezebel who calls herself a prophetess. Itching ears. And is teaching and seducing my servants to practice sexual morality and to eat food. I just told you, serve bad food. Bad food in the spirit and bad food in the natural. Bad food in the natural, pork, swine. Processed food. Medical processed food. Scientific food. Bad stuff. High fructose corn syrup, all that stuff. I repent too. That's her food. That's the devil. Right? And also that spiritual bad food. Calling the word of God old and new. Dividing the word of God. Lying about the word of God. Manipulating the word of God. Taking things out of the word of God. Preaching an itching ear gospel. Slippery slope gospel. Hyper grace gospel. You get it? And I said to this Jezebel, when the Lord in my spirit, man, identify who the spirit behind it was, because I seen it because of spiritual discernment. And that scripture came to me. He says, I gave her time to repent, but she refuses to repent. Pride, stubbornness of her sexual morality. See, she whored herself out. She whored herself out. You can't serve two masters. Hollywood, you can't say you love God. Christian, even Christian singers. You can't say you love God and be underneath Interscope Records. Even though you had a sub, you know, contract through a quote-unquote Christian company, but their covering is Interscope. And Interscope's got all types of blood and sacrifice and manipulation and killings and demonic, a murder and promoting abortion. You can't have you can't be on the fence. You can't, that's a whoremonger. I said it. You can't say that you're doing stuff for Jesus but still have a contract with the devil. Literally. You gotta get out of that covenant. God is an what? All consuming fire. God is a what? Jealous God. You can't have a contract with the devil literally and say you love Jesus. It doesn't work. You can't mix old with wineskins with new. You can't mix oil with vinegar. She refuses to repent. I met another Jezebel one time and I was sharing with her. I even got her to cry and I just said, just repent, miss, of your abortion. Repent so you could be free. And she couldn't. She couldn't. She couldn't do it. She couldn't repent of it. She was crying. She knew it was bad. And she's just like, she couldn't. And the Lord gave me this scripture. I gave her time to repent, but she refuses to repent of her sexual immorality. Behold, I will throw her onto a sick bed, and those who commit adultery with her, I will throw into great tribulation unless I repent of her works, and I will strike her children dead. And all the churches will know that I am he who searches mind and heart, and I will give to each of you according to your works. Whew! That was a lot. That was a lot. However, it's real. It's real. Pay attention. Take the mask off. God's whole truth, nothing but the truth, so help you God. Study thyself, approve. Told you I've entertained Jezebel in order to preach it to you. Had a vision before I got called out into the full-time ministry to walk by faith, and I left my job. I said, what's next? And I got a vision of what I knew was a Jezebel in my backseat of my convertible. And it's been a journey ever since. But the key word in that was repent. The key word in that is that food. Food. Jesus says what? That he is the bread. I've been seeing visions of flies on bread. Bad food. People selling out. People saying they love the Lord, but literally have Freemason contracts. Literally underneath contracts with the devil. Literally unconscious with Black Lives Matter. So that was the first topic. COVID is right with that Revelation scripture, Revelation 3. COVID's right there. COVID's a part of a judgment. You have pastors dying. Not just Catholic priests, a lot of them were Catholic, but pastors dying of COVID, getting sick, Trump getting sick, his wife getting traded. They got a little bit of that Jezebel, some greater, some higher. Look, I've been influencing underneath. It's everywhere. That's my point. That's why I was talking about the atmosphere. He always brings it back full circle. Principality. That's why the devil dilutes the word. He doesn't want you to know the keys. He doesn't want you to know all the keys you have in the Tanakh, the Torah, in the beginning of the Bible. That's all it is. It's a Bible. The beginning and the middle and the end. Whatever you want to call it. It's the beginning. It's the writings of Christ. It's the writings of apostle. But it ain't old and new. It takes the power away. Don't let the devil lie to you. Rip it out of your Bible. I did. I felt free. His word is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. Be aware of the Jezebel food. Be aware of what you put in your body. What coming from the mouth, coming from the heart. Beware of the lies of the devil and the baits of Satan, like this Trump is racist and all this stuff agenda. That's BS. You watch my videos. The Lord's already showed me what's going on. The enemy's planted people all around here to raise that up, to raise that uproar. The house divided can't stand. Will you help unite the house? In the meantime, we're about to close with Kanye West, which is coming out of Babylon. You heard it here first. Kanye West will announce and renounce his contract with Satan. And I got a surprise for you. I know who Satan is dwelling in, Judas. Yeah, I know who you are, Judas. I ain't ready to die yet. Matter of fact, even when I do declare and decree the throne of Satan and expose it by the power invested in me. Yeah, I know who I walk with. I know who I talk with. Yeah, I know who I squawk with. I know who has my back. Biggie Papa. That's who it is. The Lord spoke to me yesterday. For all you that think he's just religious, I kept hearing, I love it when you call me Big Papa. Throw your hands in the air if you's a true what? Worshippers in the house. And then Yahweh hit the then he said, oh, but hold up, what was that one song, Yahweh? Was that 80s it was a bass song. Are you with me? Oh yeah. Are you with me? Oh yeah. Go Jesus. Go Jesus. Something like that. See, when you you're in the spirit, when you don't get it all, when you can't remember all that, because you're just in that moment. And I love those moments. That's how, in more ways than one, that I know he's real. Thank you. And here we go. We're about to rock it. I had more, but you just spontaneous with it. You get the message. Yo, this rocks. Whoa, yeah. Worship. Kanye worship music.
Everything that I have, praise the Lord. With the best of portions, I know I won't forget all he's done.
He's the strength in the race that I run.
Woo!
Faithfulness.
And it shows just how much he is miraculous.
Big things popping, little things stopping. Jesus ain't stopping.
World is here.
Woo! Lord of lords. Get it, boys. Come on, Kanye. Come on.
The fire of God is coming upon you. Oh, the revelations are upon you. Oh, the end times are upon you.
And that doesn't mean that hell is always gonna win. What that really means is that the outpouring of the Holy Spirit is here. Kanye West speaking about God is that fills my cup.
Woo!
And build my
heart.
Ready?
Up my heart. The revelation. This ain't about a dead religion. Jesus brought a revelation. All the captives are forgiven. Time to break down.
Oh, yeah.
Every man, every woman, there is freedom from addiction.
Freedom from addiction.
Sunday service on the road. This is my eternal soul.
This is my kingdom.
This is my wife. This is my life. This is my God-given
body.
Thank you, Jesus, won the fight.
You guys see Trump the other day? Trump's getting it down. Come on, man. That man loves you guys. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray for our President Donald Trump as we close. Cause that's who God is. He'll take your heart, find my heart, and give you life. Give you wives. Give you what? Prizes. Give you what? Give you what? Breath. Give you what? A heart that prays. God showed me my wife, the most beautiful thing I can ever imagine. I mean, like, I had some, the gospel has opened up so many windows, so many doors, so many avenues of things I could never imagine. And I was a network and I met a lot of influential people. Sometimes I know I talk all craziness and that because I don't know what to say. I don't know how to react. But just see the fire in me. Just see it. The fire, as the Holy Spirit spoke, is here. It's upon you. It's all consuming. Be consumed. Let it change you. Let it renew you. Become one with Holy Spirit. Yeah, it looks sometimes crazy. It is eccentric. But the word says that he called us to be a peculiar people.
What you doing on the street at night? Oh.
We know you, Lord. We love you, Jesus. We love you, Jesus. I love you, Lord. No more Satan. Yeah, we cancel those assignments. We cancel those jobs of Satan. We call what? Apostolic. Positions, apostolic businesses to be available in Jesus Christ Yeshua HaMashiach's name. I'm going to jam. The devil is a liar. Because I get all nervous on here. I got to start getting like used to this. I be trying to sing without the camera and I be doing all right. And on here, that's a spirit of fear and I rebuke it. So come on, have fun with me. Come on. Help me get comfortable. Come on. Oh. It's Kanye, by the way. Use this gospel. Oh, and some of y'all that talk said, you see videos on YouTube, God don't like rap music. Shut up. Stupid, you guys don't know what you're talking about. Use this gospel for protection.
It's a hard road to heaven.
Got that right.
We call on your blessing.
Woo, Father.
We put our faith.
Kingdom,
the kingdom.
Demons are fleeing. That's what I would have said. My demons are fleeing.
In the Father, we put our faith.
The Lord just reminded me. Yeah, I get fun. President Trump. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, Yeshua HaMashiach. I just saw a video where someone says, you're the best ever. You're the most.